So I don't talk about this much, but the gym became my therapy. Just a few years ago, I was the same height and 50 pounds lighter. And I'm not a big guy. I don't have weight to lose like that. I was scrawny. I was weak, and I started coming to the gym, and it became this outlet for me, this place where I could improve myself, this place where I could escape what's going on in my life, to do something almost primitive. But it went from an outlet to an idol. And what do I look like when I take my shirt off? It's not good enough for me that, you know, when I first came in the gym, I could hardly do 5 push-ups, and now I can do push-ups like they're nothing. That's not good enough. It's not good enough to me that when I first came in the gym, I could hardly squat the bar, and now I'm squatting more than I weigh. That's not good enough. Because I always got to do more weight, lift something heavier, push something harder, run faster, jump higher, do more. It's never enough. I tell you, man, I start to feel entitled. But the gym teaches you something that's a hard lesson to learn. Just because you feel like you are owed something doesn't mean you'll get it. Just because you feel like you deserve something doesn't mean it's yours. But it's often that we grow more in our failure than in our success. This flow inside, I feel divided. Back when I ain't had a dime, but I had to drive. Back before I ever signed, I questioned life. Like, who am I, man? Woo! Nothing to me's ever good enough. I could be working for 24 hours a day and think I never did enough. My life is a movie, but there ain't no telling what you're gonna see in my cinema. I wanna be great, but I get in the way of myself and I think about everything that I could never be. Why do I do it though? Hey, yeah.